Hello everybody, my name is Petr Koutny and I'm going to show you another nice game of Mikhail Botvinnik. Mikhail Botvinnik used to be one of the best chess players of all times and of course he's still a chess legend and chess star. Anyway, and I hope you don't mind to watch this game, even this game is not such a well-known game as another his games, because this game was played too early. Okay, too early, I mean in 1927. Mikhail Botvinnik is white and his opponent Lustinov is a black. So welcome here and feel free, if you like this video, to press follow and like. So let's speak about this position. White center is his the biggest advantage. You know, c4, d4 and e4 pawns are the biggest victory for white right now in this position. So it's up to black how black will strike or attack this center. Of course, the first goal, and black is playing well, is to go first for short castle, because you know, if you are looking for attack, you need to have your king in a safe position, and for this reason it's important to play castle move. Okay, now bishop to g2 and black played knight to d7. It's a good move, of course, but I will show some more interesting moves. So let's watch a variation. c5. This is the first active move, and it's up to white how he will defend his center. For example, knight e2. Knight c6 and d5 maybe is not the best move at all, because knight is going to a5, c4 pawn is under attack, and maybe black is better here. It's a surprise that too early we are speaking about move 8, black should be better. So even a pawn center is strong. If white is not playing the best moves or good moves at all, his strong center should be at the end a weakness. And that's exactly the style of this Indian opening, because you know, black led to build white a strong center, and he believed that at the end this strong center will be weak center. So okay, black played knight to d7, and because we are watching the game of Mikhail Botvinnik, I will tell you how Mikhail Botvinnik played well this game, and of course he's playing for win. So knight to e2, c5, short castle, and black took on d4. Yes, it's a big question if black's knight is stronger on d7 or if this knight is stronger on c6. Right now it's on d7, and even this small difference are very important for this position. Okay, white took on d4, and still he's enjoying his strong center. Even his d4 pawn is gone, but still there are c4 and e4 pawns, so at least we are speaking about still a center advantage for white. Right now black is playing the same plan. He's going to attack really important white pawn on c4, so white need to play move b3. But one day, be careful if this open diagonal is weak or strong. Right now here is looking the biggest white's enemy, and this bishop on g7 is strong, and white need to be careful not to lose anything there, and of course he will not lose anything. So black need to bring all his pieces to game. This is of course a really simple way how to play chess. Just bring your pieces to game and play chess, nothing else. Bishop to b2 of course is the best move, because white's bishop on b2 need to be as good as a black's bishop on g7, and this is really important to not lose this really important open diagonal. Knight is jumping back to c6. I'm not sure if this move is the best move at all, because you know, this knight on e5 is the best black's piece, and he is jumping back, so something happened, and maybe black believe for exchanging. Okay, if black is coming back, it's a good idea to go forward. So knight to d5 is the best move at all. Interesting was another move back and knight to e2. Okay, let's speak about move. What's the reason behind this move, knight to c6? I think that white has more space, so for black it's good to exchange few pieces, and this is exactly well-known chess rule. If you don't have space, just exchange pieces. So maybe after move knight to c6 is not at all the bad move knight to e2 and not exchange pieces, because white has space advantage. That's cool idea, but you know, Botvinnik is don't mind to exchange another piece. So for example, right now he should exchange two, maybe three minor pieces, and that's exactly interesting, because you know, exactly, we know if you have space, don't exchange too much pieces, and sometimes this example is working, sometimes this example is not working. For this reason, it's good to watch this game, because Mikhail Botvinnik, of course, is playing amazing chess. So, one exchange, another exchange, and you know, looks like black is absolutely okay, because he managed to exchange two minor pieces, and probably another is going to be exchanged soon. And you know, where is white's advantage after move b5? Okay, I will tell you that white is taking on g7. Of course, he is improving his queen. Watch queen on d1 and watch the difference between d1 queen and d4 queen. That's of course the story, how to improve our pieces, how to get stronger pieces, and how to stay in good position, in good shape. You know, side with better pieces has advantage. So queen on d4 is absolutely stronger once, twice, three times than queen on d8. So check. Of course, black need to go anywhere. And okay, what to play? For example, move c5 looks interesting. Why not to go forward? And I'm going to show you another interesting variation. So I think black is taking a6, d6. Okay, this position is open, small edge here for white, but how big? I don't know, you know, too many pieces exchanged, and of course even here I believe in white's advantage. But let's come back. This game is not such a simple example how to play chess. This is game coming from Mikhail Botvinnik hands, and he took on b5. You know, the main idea here, I believe, is advantage 2 pawns against 1. If these pawns are going forward, they should be strong. Another small problem for black is a weak pawn on e7. And let's speak about space. Even this bishop looks like bad piece, and this pawn is great, and this pawn is winning another space. So I believe that black is a lack of space. You know, this is a terrible picture, how such a small weakness or such a small disadvantage is in good hands, good chance for victory. You know, black of course was not playing bad moves at all, he was playing okay moves, but space is important, and maybe in case of space it's good to watch this game till end and to learn from Mikhail Botvinnik. So rook to e1 of course makes sense to attack immediately the black's weakness, and of course here is open c file, so it's good idea to have two rooks in open C file. I believe that the C file is the most important file right now here, and it's up to white or black how they will play this chess. So rook to e3. Of course, the main idea is rook to e1 and attack on e7, or to place two rooks on open C file, or in case of move g4, maybe there should be attack against black's king, and there's a surprise plan. So you know, too many options, and black need to be careful about all of them, because even one, even two, or even all white's plans are cool, are strong, and black need to be careful. F5, okay, I'm not sure if F5 is the best move at all. Up to me, this could be a mistake. I will tell you that this square is weak, and weaker. And these rooks are still doing nothing, and Black's king is a little bit more weak or weaker than before. So I don't like f5 move at all. I think c5 is the most important file, or just still go there and exchange something. So a4 and rook e1. So the difference between white pieces and the black pieces is in their activity. You know, if you don't count with bishop on g2, all white pieces are stronger. That's cool to have stronger pieces in open position, and it's up to you if you prefer black's position or white's position. But up to me, I should rather play this position for white, not for black. Just I will show black's position. You know, white rooks are stronger. White queen is absolutely cool, and you know, even bishop on g2 is doing a good job. So black is not active. I don't see any counterplay, and I don't see what to play if I am black. You know, even here is a big threat to go b4, b5, a5, b6, b7 and a7. These two pawns nearly in every endgame are strong, and black is really in bad shape of this game, and he needs to do something. So he played rook to f7. B4 as good move, as I believe, because b5 is in the air, and b5 happened immediately. So a5 and another pawn moves are there. a6. I think this should be the losing mistake, because it's not good at all to play with pawns where you are weaker. Maybe rook to c8, say lose good, but black is losing pawn here, and it's not good to lose pawn at all. And of course this position is lost for black, because two pawns are going forward and nobody will stop them. So for this reason it's good to keep the pawn on a7, but if black is trying to keep this pawn on a7, he's playing without rook on a8, and that's strange for him. You know, he's a really important piece. A rook need to cover not important pawn on a7. No, this pawn is important in endgame. It's not important in middle game, but we are not far from the endgame, and for this reason black need to do something with this pawn, and he's playing move a6. Okay, b6, and this pawn is only two moves from a victory. So black is, you know, even not under attack, but I think black is under big pressure. Move by move, it's like white's pressure is getting bigger and bigger, and black's passivity is of course bigger and bigger as well. So black's problems are bigger, and it's up to black if he's able to find energy how to stop white. So to c8, a5, these two pawns are winning pawns in nearly every endgame. Right now, it's not a question if white is winning, it's a question when white is winning. Okay, rook to c5 and rook to c3. I like this move. I will tell you why. The most active black piece is rook on c5. This rook is only one active piece, the last active piece, and it's a great idea to exchange the most active black piece. And of course, if you know which piece is the most active, just go there and exchange, because if you are going to exchange the most active piece, you will leaving blacks only with passive and bad pieces. So that's happened. Okay, it's a question if black has time to take on a5. I think no, because black is losing a piece. So that's not a good idea, and you know, everything is working against black. Exchange favored white, and queen to a3, attack on a7. Okay, what's going on if black is going to f7? Another weakness is, for example, e6, exchange, change, and of course black is losing piece. So you know, looks like in this position there are no threats. There is no danger, but every variation is giving you answer that yes, here are dangers, and black is in bad shape, and black need to do something, but what? This is a hard question, you know? Remember, black is playing against Mikhail Botvinnik, and that's not funny to play this position. So, open a c5 belong white, change, check, and this endgame is gone. Okay, maybe queen to g7, take, and this endgame is gone as well. So let's come back. Black took, but who will stop a move b7? And I will tell you that nobody. And of course, this endgame is not hard to play for white, and black resign here. What we saw, if you are watching till now, thank you very much for watching, and thank you very much for the likes and follows. We saw cool game, you know, looks like from nothing, only space advantage, you know, more activity and stronger pieces was enough to win this game, and I agree. This game was not the most exciting game of chess history, but it was interesting because we saw how small advantages are enough to play for win, and we saw how Mikhail Botvinnik outplayed his opponent. So I hope, I believe, I'm sure that you saw interesting game, and that's all. So thank you very much for watching, and I hope I will see you soon in our another YouTube chess video. See you soon. Bye bye.